Alright, I think this ain't a bad way of informing you all what's going on. Now, if you thought this was gonna be a programming tutorial or something, I'm sorry, but it's not. But don't quit just now, cause I'm gonna mention some stuff relevant to the series. So basically, this channel ain't gonna be just about Half-Life programming, but I'm well aware that I've been uploading nothing else for the past year or so. There's a lot of exciting stuff coming to this channel, and while I can't make any guarantees, here's a list of ideas, some of which might be a reality as of sometime next year, albeit in no particular order. The first one, and probably the most likely one, is Half-Life mapping. I'd be showing how to make maps with Jack and Trench Broom. This would include various things like creating terrain, pipes, cool entity sequences, and stuff like that. From basics to advanced stuff, basically. Next up, we got game development with idTech engines. So this means engines like Quake, Quake 2, and Quake 3's engine. This also includes Doom 3, the idTech 4 engine. As you might know, I've also made a fork of IO Quake 3, which is entirely in C++ and makes it feel more like HL SDK. But let me tell you, those were quite some adventures. It would probably make for an interesting series. How to work with these engines, how to build them from source code, how to actually develop a game with them, and stuff like that. Now, the next one would be Half-Life SDK Extras. Let me ask you a question. Do you find a programming series boring? Do you want to integrate a physics engine to Half-Life? Or do you want to replace Half-Life's audio system to play high-quality sounds? Do you want to rewrite the render? Maybe. Well, if the answer to any of those questions is yes, then Half-Life SDK Extras is gonna be just for you. It's gonna be a mishmash of super crazy ideas. Crazy enough to be entertaining, but not something that takes 5 years to make. Frankly, though, each of these could become its own series, like integrating a physics engine or rewriting the render, because those are very broad topics. But anyway, these will be more like high-level overviews of how to develop certain features without explaining the very basics like in the programming series. Like, come on, I ain't gonna explain what a pointer is. In these videos, I expect you to know a bit about software architecture, working with libraries, some design patterns, and stuff like that. You know, like actual software development things. Next up, I've actually been doing this for a while before my channel took off, and that's making devlogs. Now, back in the day, I made devlogs for my Half-Life mod base called ADM, and they were pretty boring. Once I finished a massive cleanup of ADM, I'll start making these devlogs again. If you don't know what ADM is, I put a link to it in the description. But to put it shortly, it's gonna be a mod base with a bunch of new entities for mappers and some really nice tech for programmers, but also is gonna have some cool stuff in general, like high quality audio and a vehicle system. The next one would be mod and map postmortems. Now here I could talk about how I made some maps like Day Kabel or TS Untergrund, and we could learn a thing or two from my experiences in my earlier days when I was just a mapper. I could also do something like a personal modding history series where I talk about how I started mapping, which tools I used back then, which tools I use now, and how things changed, how my skills evolved, and so on. Anyway, what's next? Oh yeah, by the way, these devlogs wouldn't be just about ADM. I could make devlogs for my library projects or other bigger projects such as my currently in progress engine, which only really consists of a couple of utility classes and a file system right now. And for the end, what happens after Half-Life SDK programming? Like, I mean, it's gonna take a while, let's be real. If I keep going at a pace of 2 videos per month, which is pretty much the fastest I can do right now, I'll finish the programming series in about 2 years. This is gonna take a while. But the point is, what's gonna happen when the series does end? Well, assuming we don't get a source to SDK for the next 3 years, I'll start a series for the source SDK. Interestingly, my first video in the series mostly got its views from people searching source engine tutorial. And I mean, I knew this was gonna happen, like source and gold source, well, they're kind of synonymous. Kind of. But still, I mean, I love that people are still interested in watching this stuff despite it being for gold source. And speaking of statistics, I honestly gotta say, like, wow, this really destroyed all my expectations and blew them up to the skies. There aren't that many Half-Life modders nowadays, so I believe the first video would maybe have 500 views in a year. Turns out, it got 20 times more than that. It's incredibly satisfying and incredibly motivating, not gonna lie. Like, seriously, this This first video just doesn't want to die. It's still getting more views per day than any of my other videos. But there's a problem. Since it was my first video in the series, I had a really bad recording setup. Like, my brother was in the room typing on his keyboard, the AC was humming, our PCs were humming, because like there was a bunch of dust in them and the fans were loud. And I was recording the audio on my phone. The audio quality was just so bad. Like, if you go now and listen to it and listen to this video, you're gonna notice a drastic change in audio quality.
Have you ever wondered, how the heck do entities work on the inside?
Nowadays, well, I recently cleaned my PC so it's a lot quieter, and as I'm recording this, my brother is in school, so the room is pretty much quiet. And I got a new microphone in February, so that's pretty nice. And yeah, all this leads me to legitimately considering remaking that video next month. And I don't just mean remake as in like re-record the audio, no. I mean restructuring some of it and reimagining the other parts. In other words, I'm gonna take the good parts of it and make them even better. And here you can see these, like, actual, you know, graphs and stuff. Anyway, a week before I uploaded part 0 introduction, I had approximately 80 subscribers. Nowadays, that number is about 760. That's almost 10 times the growth in less than a year. And that's really amazing, and I'm thankful to say the least, because that means that there are people interested in this kind of stuff. So that's really nice. But numbers don't really matter that much to me, like the number of individual views and stuff like that. But the thing that really made me happy was when I saw new people getting interested in Half-Life modding. I've seen people entering the TWHL Discord and saying stuff like, "Admir's videos brought me here." That's the coolest thing ever. And some of those people are now working on really cool projects. That is what makes me really happy. Because I got somebody to enter this Half-Life modding community and actually grow their skills and make cool things. That is the entire point of these videos. Now, so with all that said, my core plan seems to be working after all. The main goal with this tutorial series is basically to make Half-Life mod programming a bit more accessible to people and roughly guide people around the SDK who already know programming but aren't familiar with any of the APIs or stuff like that. As for the huge gap between part 0, part 1 and 1.1, well, I was finishing high school and I had a bunch of tests and then I had to sign up for college. Nowadays I have a more regular schedule where in the worst case scenario my output would be one video every 2 months. I imagine it's gonna be this way when I have like exams in college and stuff like that, and at best it's probably 2 to 3 videos per month. I do not think I can go faster than that due to my quality standards and all other projects I'm working on. My college classes are probably gonna start in about a week, and I honestly don't know what to expect. I don't know how much time I'll have or lack, and I don't know how it'll impact my schedule. Now, finally, as far as the programming series goes, here's my plan at the moment. So, in February, we might finally arrive to weapons. Oh boy, that's really a complicated, like, issue. Weapons in the Half-Life SDK, that's really, really tough for beginners, because there's a lot of stuff in there. So until then, we're gonna do a bunch of like other stuff, you know. We're also gonna look at like trace lines, which if you're coming from Unity, Godot, or any other modern engine, that's basically ray casting. How do you check if a bullet hits something? How do you check if an NPC sees something? You use a trace line, obviously. And there are gonna be a bunch of other model related things like hitboxes, attachments, animation events, controlling animated models, like controlling their bones individually with controllers, like when the scientists open their mouth while talking, stuff like that. Now, this plan can change at any time, but I hope it gives you an idea. And this is what I've done up to this point. You can see that I got a lot of stuff on my plate every month, and I imagine I'll be able to do a lot less things per month when college starts. So yeah, that's about it for this month. I guess in the next status update, I'll probably whine about college and how I don't have time for anything, but yeah, we'll see what happens.